The Narendra Modi government has completed its 100 days in power. Modi, throughout his campaign for the Lok Sabha elections, had hit out at the UPA too for not controlling the high inflation. After assuming office in May, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has taken a slew of measures to bring the derailed economy on a growth path. However, after 3 months of the NDA government at the centre, the highly publicised campaign promise of Acche Din is yet to be delivered. Within 1 month after forming the NDA government, Modi had asked people to swallow bitter pills for better days and increase the rail fare, prices of non-subsidized LPG gas cylinders and petrol and diesel prices, leaving people to reel under high inflation. Government had also failed to control the prices of essential commodities such as onion and tomatoes.
कुछ विषय आज पोस्टपोन कर दिए गए क्योंकि संबंधित मंत्री नहीं थे। दो महत्वपूर्ण निर्णय के बारे में मैं आपको बता देता हूं। बाकी जो इकोनॉमिक अफेयर्स कमेटी में, पॉलिटिकल अफेयर्स कमेटी में या कैबिनेट के फैसले हैं वो अभी अपलोड हो जाएंगे। एक महत्वपूर्ण निर्णय यह है कि आपको मालूम है कि पूर्ववर्ती सरकार ने 28 फरवरी 2014 को एक फैसला किया था कि हम 12 सिलेंडर सब्सिडाइज लोगों को देंगे हर साल, लेकिन उसकी एक शर्त थी कि एक सिलेंडर आपको हर महीने लेना पड़ेगा। आज की बैठक में ऐसा पाया गया कि उसके कारण लोगों को बहुत असुविधा हो रही है। कई बार लोगों को एक की आवश्यकता नहीं होती है, कई बार फेस्टिवल सीजन होता है, उनके यहाँ मेहमान हो जाते हैं तो अधिक ज़रूरत पड़ती है। तो ऐसा अनुभव आ रहा था कि अगर किसी ने एक सिलेंडर एक महीने में नहीं लिया तो बाकी महीने में उसको नहीं मिलेगा। तो आज की कैबिनेट की बैठक में जनता की सुविधा को देखते हुए उस कंडीशन को समाप्त कर दिया।
However, setting the tone for the next 5 years, the Narendra Modi government had presented a populist but growth-oriented budget on July 10th. In his maiden budget, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley had initiated several measures to boost Indian economy. The key economic highlights of the government include hiking FDI cap in insurance and defence sector from existing 26% to 49%, besides a boost to manufacturing sector through the Make in India slogan. Addressing from the ramparts of the Red Fort, Modi in his Independence Day speech announced the scrapping of decades-old Body Planning Commission. The government had also abolished 21 GOMs and 9 EGOMs, and departments were asked to resolve pending issues among themselves.
Currently, we permit 26% FDI in defence manufacturing. The composite cap of foreign exchange is being raised to 49% with full management control, Indian management and control through the FIPB route.
So far in these months, Modi government has given a particular emphasis on agriculture, infrastructure, manufacturing and power sector. Government has also unveiled a major initiative to boost irrigation across the country. In its maiden budget, the decision to launch GST, reviving special economic zones, building 100 smart cities, promoting small industries and heavy spending on infrastructure and addressing the drinking water and sanitation problems will definitely reboot Indian economy. In a major step, the Modi government had recommended several amendments in the Factories Act for improving safety of workers and relaxing the norms for women to work in some industry segments at night. The amendments in the Act also ensures penalty for violations of any Act.
To encourage development of smart cities, which will also provide habitation for this new middle class, requirement of the built-up area of capital conditions for FDI is being reduced from 50,000 square meters to 20,000 square meters and from $10 million to $5 million, respectively, with a 3-year post-completion lock-in. To further encourage these projects, which commit at least 30% of the total project costs for low-cost affordable housing, will be exempted for the minimum built-up area and capitalization requirements with conditions of 3-year lock-in.
Powered by NNIS.